Hallelujah. Amen. You're happy to be in the house of the Lord this morning. Amen. Just lift up your hands and just thank Him. Amen. Give Him praise. Amen. For the life. Amen. And the opportunity that we have this morning to come back and to give Him all the praise and the glory. Amen. He's great in our midst today. We know that He's God over us. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. I'm no longer slave to fear. Oh, I am a child of God. I'm no longer slave to fear. Oh, I am I'm a child of God. Oh, You unraveled me. Oh, with a melody. Oh, and You surround me with a song. Oh, of deliverance. Oh, yes, from my enemies, till Lord, my fears are. Oh, I'm no longer a slave to fear. Oh, this morning and I'm a child. Oh, I'm no longer a slave to fear. Who I am, sing I am a child. Oh, from my mother's womb this morning, sing from my mother's womb. Oh, He chose us this morning. You have chosen me. Oh, sing, love has called my. Oh, been born again. I've been born again. Oh, into a family. Your blood flows through my. Oh, I'm no longer a slave to fear. I'm a child of. Oh, I'm no longer a slave to fear. Oh, I am a child. I am a child of God. Oh, I'm no longer. Oh, I am a child, we sing. I am a child of God. Oh, I pledge allegiance to the Lamb with all my strength. Hallelujah, we all. And I will seek you out. Oh, His commands. Oh, I pledge allegiance to who I pledge. I pledge to the Lamb, it all my strength in all I am. Oh, I say to God, oh, yes, I bet I live to God, give him thanks and praise this morning. Oh, hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Father, we know, oh God, this morning that our hearts are fixed on that sure belief of God. And nothing can shake that belief. Nothing can touch that belief this morning. Why? Because, Lord, oh, we've been made so in the program of the Lord. Hallelujah. To give praise, to give glory, and to give honor, Lord. Oh, and we constantly remaining here, patiently waiting, because we know our God is coming and coming again. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Thank you, Jesus, this morning. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. We appreciate the Lord. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. You're welcome back into the house. Amen. Of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. You have your Bibles right now, and turn with me to the book. Let's read Psalm 44.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Psalm 44. We have heard with our ears how God our fathers have told us. Oh God, our fathers have told us. What work thou didst in their days, in the times of old. How thou dost drive out the heathen with thy hand and plantest them. How thou dost afflict the people and cast them out. For they got not the land in possession by their own sword, neither did their own arm save them, but thy right hand and thy arm and the light of thy countenance, because thou hast a favor unto them. Thou art my King, O God, command deliverance for us this morning. Blessed be the name of the Lord. You love him this morning. Amen. Shall we lift our hands and give him praise, give him glory, give him honor, for he is the same God yesterday, today, and forever. Amen. If he commanded deliverance for Jacob, he will command deliverance for us this season. And that's our prayer. What a present tense testimony. Amen. To behold upon us this morning. Father, Lord, we confess it this morning that truly, Lord, at the mention of your name, we had life, we had strength. Oh God, joy unspeakable and full of glory, Lord God, and that joy gave us an expectation, Lord Jesus, and directed our paths here this morning for a purpose. Lord God, we come this morning that may that purpose be filled in our hearts, be filled in our day, oh, and we be witnesses to it this morning, Lord God, and let us, oh hallelujah, be those vessels, be those tools in the warehouse that which you would use, Lord God. Accomplish your word this morning, Father, and we surrender all unto thee, Lord God. And may, oh God, we this morning, oh, may we be used greatly in the service of the Lord, for that is my purpose, that is our purpose, and that is why we come this morning. We own not our own lives, but we know our lives are owned by God himself, and he does what he wants to do with that life, and that is what we come, oh God, to answer, Father, this morning at the call of thy word today in our hearts, Lord Jesus. Lord, and this call, amen, is a call written in love that can be extended to family, to our kindred, hallelujah, to our loved ones, Lord, and even they that love us or have done good unto, oh God, oh hallelujah, one of your anointed this morning, we pray that may we all be anointed in this service, Father, and may we leave you with a testimony. Lord, I don't know why all have come this morning, but some came because, Father, Lord God, in their sleepless night, you gave them comfort, Father. Lord, when they were troubled, Father, oh God, you gave them a promise. You gave them an encouraging word, and they held on to that word and have found peace this morning. Lord, we come all together, oh God, with diverse of thanksgivings, Father. But Lord, this morning, may they be directed towards your throne, oh God. And may our lives, oh God, be a change this morning onward, Father. When we commit the entire service into your hands and the preaching of the word that comes later on today, Father, that may we all live here with our heart filled with the word of God. Such a great purpose for us this morning. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Amen. Oh, you love him this morning. Blessed be the name of our Lord. Amen. You can turn and just welcome somebody this morning. I love you with the love of the Lord. Oh, say, yes, I love you with the love of the Lord. Oh, I can see in you, oh, the glory of the Lord. Oh, I love you with the love of the Lord. Oh, I love you, I love you with. Oh, yes, this morning. Oh, such love is in. I love you with love of the Lord. Oh, I can see in you. Oh, the glory of. Oh, hallelujah. I love you with the love of the Lord. Oh, sing, I love you with a, oh, hallelujah. Oh, oh, the Lord. Oh, I love you with the love of the Lord. Oh, cause I can see in you, oh, the glory of. Oh, yes, I love you with the love of the Lord. Oh, we sing, praise him. Oh, praise him in the morning. Oh, praise him mighty. Oh, sing, praise him, praise him. Oh, we sing, praise him. Oh, praise him when the sun goes. Oh, we will serve him, sir. Oh, serve him this morning. We will serve him. Serve him, serve him, serve him, serve him. In the morning and serve him at noon. We will serve him, serve him, serve him, serve him, hallelujah, serve him. Oh, when the sun, oh, we will love him this morning, love. Oh, just love him this morning, love him, love. Oh, love him, man. Hallelujah, love him up. Sing, love him, love him, love. Oh, we love him, love him. Oh, love him. Oh, when the sun goes down. Oh, you love him this morning. Amen. You ready to serve him this morning. To give him all the praise, amen, and the glory he deserved, and the honor he deserves. Father, this morning you are great, amen. You've done all, and we have seen it all this morning, Father. Amen and amen. Thank you, Jesus, this morning. We love him this morning. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Are you love him this morning? Amen. Have you been blessed, amen, in the course of the week? Amen, that I've just gone by. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. We have, amen, thanksgiving here this morning. He says, brethren, please join hands with me. Thank the Lord for many mercies granted me to the village and back. I also want to thank the Lord for delivering us from multiple accidents. Glory be to God. Amen, brother. Amen. Brother, amen. Wusahana. God richly bless you. Amen. Sister Hannah, amen. Kawuli W. Hannah. God bless you. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. This next one comes from Sister Adelaide. Amen. It says, I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continually be in my mouth. Dear saints of the living God, help me thank the Lord for his grace, love, guidance, and protection upon my life. The Lord has been good and has never failed me, and always coming true for me. I thank the Lord for adding an additional year to my age today. I pray he leads me on, amen, the right path, and make me live the way he wants me to, and above all, fill me with his Holy Spirit. Amen. And God bless us all. Amen. You're happy today. Amen. That the Lord is doing wonders. Amen. It's a great miracle to be able to live a whole year. Amen. But people do not recognize it. Amen. But we know what goes into that. Hallelujah. Amen. To embark on a journey. Amen. Such far. Amen. And come back with your life. Amen. We know what the God is doing behind the scene. Amen. There is somebody doing something right. Amen. It is not your making. It is not you knowing what to do. Amen. At what time, but it is something doing something. Amen. Behind the scene. Amen. To make sure that your life is sustained. And that is why we come back with those testimonies. Amen. To acknowledge the presence of the Lord in our lives. For it wouldn't be possible if he wasn't around. Amen. Some tried it, and today, hallelujah, they are not with us this day. But we thank the Lord, and we know exactly who did it. Let us lift up our hands together and join my brother. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. My sisters, to thank the Lord for what is done. Father, we give you the praise and we give you the glory. Lord God, that, amen, your presence has been with us all this while. Amen. Hasn't left us. Amen. Even when we are down, Lord God, we thank you, Father, for protecting lives, Lord Jesus. Lord God, we give you all the praise and the glory, Lord, for granting, amen, Sister Hannah, who said, come with you, Lord, to the village, Father, Lord, and bringing sin back, oh God. Amen, amen, protecting them and delivering them from multiple accidents. Lord, the enemy has always come, amen, to try to kill in the physical. Amen, to stop the praise, to stop the worship of God. Oh Lord, but he has failed multiple times. Amen, because you were there in the scene. Lord God, and you protected, Father, and you held on, Lord Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, for them, Father. Lord, and today, oh hallelujah, oh we sing that victory. We acknowledge it unto you, oh God, and praise and worship, Father, because you have done it again. We thank you, Father. Lord, we want to give you praise, glory, and honor again. And thank you, Lord Jesus, for granting our sister Adelaide, Lord, amen, an additional year to her age. Today, oh God, is a day, Father, oh, that she has come to give you glory and thanksgiving, Lord, for what you have done for us, Lord Jesus. That Lord, in this life, Lord, in Christ Jesus, and that is what, oh, hallelujah, oh, that makes it all. That is what the reason is, oh God, today, to live in Christ. Lord, God is the greatest gift ever. Amen. Father, we bless your name. Lord, we thank you, Father. Lord, for all the blessings, oh God, you've bestowed upon the bride here. Lord, this past week and years, Lord God, and we pray that may your glory be praised, may your name be lifted high, and may our hearts, oh God, continually be of thanksgiving unto thee. In Jesus' name we pray with thanksgiving. Amen and amen. Amen. You love the Lord this morning. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Amen and amen. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, everywhere he went, oh yes, he was doing good. Oh yes, them. Hallelujah, he healed them. Oh, when the crippled saw him, oh, they started walking. Well, everywhere he went, man. Oh, everywhere he went. Oh, yes, he was. Hallelujah, the mighty. Oh, he healed. Oh, hallelujah. When they saw him, well, he started walking. Oh, yes, everywhere he. Oh, my Lord was doing good. Oh, we sing now, Jesus, I'll never forget what you've done for me. Well, now, Jesus, I'll never forget well, how you set me free. Jesus, Jesus, I'll never forget. Oh, how you brought me out. We sing now, Jesus, I'll never. Well, oh, never. My Jesus, Jesus, I'll never forget. Well, how. Oh, yes, now, Jesus, I'll never. Oh, how you set me free. Well, now, Jesus, I'll never forget. Well, how you brought me out. My Jesus, Jesus, I'll never. Well, oh, never. Sing now, well, he brought me out from the mighty. Oh, he set my feet on a rock to stay. Put a song. Oh, hallelujah. Well, a song today. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, he brought me out of rock. Amen, Sister Adley. Oh, hallelujah. And he set my feet on a rock to say, put a song in my soul. Well, a song of praise. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. Amen. You love him today. Amen. You may be seated. Amen. Amen. Sister Adelaide, amen, has a special today. Amen. And the title is, I've Not Seen a Mountain. You love him?
No, I don't know your problem. I don't know the trials that you face. And I don't know God's will. But I can tell you, I know His grace. So just keep on climbing. And by faith, understand. If He's not moved your mountain, you better believe that He can.
Blessed, blessed be the name of the Lord. Amen, 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 amen. Hallelujah! Can you see a mountain? Oh, that our God cannot move. There's no such mountain. There's no such situation. There is nothing that the Lord cannot turn around. Oh, just call unto that master. Amen, and see what He will do. Amen, it is not for you to try to force it. It is just for you to pray, put it in the hands of the Lord. Amen. And keep your peace and watch the move of the Lord. Amen. Around that prayer, and you will wake up one day. Amen. And see that mountain no more. You will see, hallelujah, oh, that mountain no more. Amen. That's how He works it. Amen. That is how it is done. Hallelujah. And that is what I believe today. I know that is what you believe this morning. Amen. That's no mountain. That's no situation. Oh, hallelujah. That a master cannot do. That a master cannot move today. Oh, hallelujah. It says within a twinkling of an eye. Amen. And that mountain is vanished. Oh, give Him praise this morning. Amen. God bless you, Sister Adley. Amen. For that great testimony. I know heaven is a place this morning. Amen. Full hallelujah. With the incense of praise rising from here. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Oh, bless you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Amen and amen and amen. Amen. Just turn around and greet somebody. Amen. Let's sing a song before we cross over today. Well, I'm pressing on all with all. That I know I'm pressing on. Oh, on. Oh, yes, we run. That I know I'm pressing on. Oh, to the city. Oh, where a mansion is prepared. I'm pressing on, I'm pressing on. Oh, yes, on me, on. That I know I'm pressing on. Oh, yes, on me, on. That I know I'm pressing on. Oh, to the city. Oh, where a mansion is prepared. Oh, and I feel like sing, I feel like go. Oh, yeah, sing, I feel like going home. Oh, yes, those trials may come over me. We hear, I feel like going home. Amen. Shall we pray for a tithes and offering this morning? Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Father, we just want to commit the tithes and the offering into your hands. Lord, that may it be blessed, Father, for the furtherance of your kingdom. In Jesus' name we pray, amen and amen. I feel like going home. Oh, sing, I feel like going home. Though trials may come, well from me. Hallelujah, I feel like going home. Oh, there's a song the holy angels cannot sing. With amazing grace. Oh, yes, I see the sound. Well, there's a song the holy angels cannot sing. Oh, I once was lost. Oh, but now I'm. Oh, that's a song the holy angels cannot sing. Amazing praise. Oh, hallelujah, sweet the sound. There's a song the holy angels cannot. Oh, I once was lost. Oh, we sing, but now. Oh, that's a song the holy angels cannot sing. Hallelujah, oh amazing grace. Well, how sweet the sound that says song the holy angels cannot. Oh, as I once was lost, but now. Oh, one more time sing that says song the holy angels. Oh, hallelujah, amazing grace. Oh, sweet the sound, that's a song the holy angels cannot sing. Oh, yes, I once was lost, sing, but now I'm found. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Amen, amen, amen. This morning, amen. Shall we just pray, Father? We thank you, Lord. We bless the preaching of the word this morning unto us, Father. Lord, even as we hear these words, Lord, coming, O God, from your mind, from your throne, Lord Jesus, may you bless it upon us, Father. And when we leave this place, let those words, oh, hallelujah, be a reflection of our lives. Let those words come in us and reflect, Father, that everywhere we go, amen, the people will see Christ in us, in the way we discharge our daily duties and activities and go about our normal activity, Father. Oh, God, let us apply the word. Oh God and your Lord Jesus, everything that you bring on this morning. We are under expectation, Father. Strengthen your servant, oh God. And back him up this morning with physical strength. And we know in the spirit you take care of it, Father. Bless the people, Lord, by the preaching of the word today. In Jesus' name we pray. Oh, you love him this morning. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. Are you under expectation this morning? Thank you, Lord. Amen. I've got my mind made up and I won't turn back because I want to see my Jesus someday. I've got my mind made up, oh, and I won't turn back because I want to see my Jesus someday. Sing, I've got my mind made up, oh, and I won't turn back, oh, because I want to see my Jesus someday. Oh, I've got my mind made up, and I won't turn back, because I want to see my Jesus someday. Oh, goodbye world, oh, I stay. Oh yes, pleasures. Oh yes, I stay no longer with you. I've made up my mind to go that way the rest of my life. Oh, I've made up my mind to go that way the rest of my life. Oh, I've got my mind made up. Oh, when I would. Oh, yes, because I want to see my Jesus someday. Oh, I've got my mind made up. Oh, when I would turn back, because I want to see my Jesus someday. Oh, it's a highway to heaven. Hallelujah, none can walk up there. Oh, but the pure in heart. Well, it's a highway to heaven. Oh, walking up the King's highway. Oh, we say hi, highway to heaven. Oh, none can walk up. Hallelujah, but the pure. Oh, it's a highway. It's a highway. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, this morning, walking up the King's highway. Oh, yes, one more time, sing. It's a highway to heaven. Oh, none can walk up there. Hallelujah. But the pure. Oh, sing. It's a highway to heaven. Oh, walking up the King's highway. Oh, with the same spirit will that lift Christ from the dead. Oh, dwelling here, dwell. Oh, if that same spirit will that lift Christ from the dead. Oh, yes, dwells. Oh, hallelujah, dwelling here. Oh,
you know we shall speak it. Oh, your mortal body, if that spirit, if that same spirit dwell in you, it shall quicken. Oh, your mortal body, oh, if that same spirit dwell in you. One more time, sing, if that same spirit that raised Christ from the dead dwell in you. If it dwell in you, if that same now, if that same spirit that raised Christ from the dead dwell in you. Oh, if it dwell in you, you know it shall quicken your mortal body. Oh Lord, if that same spirit dwell in you, it shall quicken. Oh, your mortal body. Oh Lord, if that same spirit dwell in you for the last time, if that same spirit that raised Christ from the dead dwell in you. If that same now, if that same spirit that raised Christ from the dead, if it dwell in you, if it dwell in you, you know it shall quicken your mortal body. Oh Lord, if that same spirit dwell in you, it shall quicken. Oh, your mortal body. Same spirit dwell in you. Amen. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. That's our desire, that the spirit that raised Christ from the dead, it will dwell in you. That's what identifies you as a Christian. Praise God, amen. Praise God. Oh, you love him tonight. You love him this morning. Praise God. Amen, amen, amen. So we thank God for his grace. The spirit must dwell in us. Amen. That is the identification. You know, the spirit, Christ was the word. The word was made flesh and dwelt among us. And when he was living, he said, I will come again. Amen. And be with you, even in you. So the spirit is the word today. And the word is the seed. So the spirit is the seed today. Praise God. Amen. It must be in you, living in you. Then it can quicken your mortal body. It can change your thinking, can change your desires. It can make you live like a son of God. What? The spirit. Amen. That's why I said the letter kill it, but the spirit give it life. Because this is the manifestation, the time for the manifestation of the spirit, which is the word. So you get the written word, but the spirit quickens it to your soul. Then it becomes a living word. Then we can say, now we are the sons of God. Amen. So we thank God for his grace. Thank him for bringing us one more time to another day of worship. Amen. We never get weary. We can never get weary. Praise God. Amen, amen. Amen. And so, like I announced, we're going to have elections next week. Amen. When the prophet said that you may be seated just before go to the word. Amen. Just to remind you, Brother Bram said, the first thing I wish to say is that the pastor is always, not that place. Amen. Church order verse 3. He said, we believe in apostolic church. We believe in an apostolic church, teaching apostolic blessings for the people of this day. We believe in the full gospel and believe that all the signs and wonders that were spoken of by our Lord Jesus Christ would accompany his church until he returns. So we believe in that. We believe in those things and believe that they are to be set in order. That the church has its order. Each church has its doctrine and order and discipline. Praise God. Amen. And our church here has no members as joiners. So we don't join the church. Today I want to be a member of this church. Then we have a book, register. Then we write the date. We write your name and your age and the date you joined. Praise the Lord. And from there we start marking you as a member of the church. No, we don't have that. We believe that the whole universal church of the living God is our brothers and sisters. Praise the Lord. So once you believe in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, amen, you are baptized into the body, you are welcome to fellowship with us. Become a member of the church. Amen. And so he said, we believe that the whole universal church of the living God is our brothers and sisters, and that all the people are always welcome, regardless of what denomination they belong to. Amen. So if you belong to Deeper Life, you are welcome. You belong to Church of Christ, you are welcome. You belong to any, you are welcome. We don't have members. It's the body of Christ. Praise God. But when you come, the word, you must line up with the word of God for your day. Pray. Once you accept that word for your day, brother, you are my brother, you are my sister. So the Brahm continued and said here that now, he said, and that is the first thing is placing of some deacons into the church. And our little church here is sovereign. It doesn't have any denomination or anything to send its deacons. It elects its own deacons, its pastors, its trustees. It elects everything that comes in and out of the church. No one has the say-so over anything is the church. And the church are those who come. Are you getting now? So the church are those who come and support the church with their presence. So you have to be here. Every day your seat must be here. Your presence. Are you getting it? And then you support the church with your presence, with your tithes, and with your offering. Are always the one that has the legal say-so in the placing of such. Are you getting me? So if you are a member, you just come and occupy a chair here. You don't support the church with your tithes and your offering. You have no right to vote. Oh, is that so? But I'm here every day. Yeah, of course, yes, you are. Praise the Lord. We believe in apostolic church, right? Huh? Praise God. Amen. That's what we believe in. So the prophet said here that we believe in that. He said those who support with their tithe and offering. So if you believe in Church of Christ doctrine of not paying tithes, you are not part of the church. You might come here with all kinds of every day, but you don't believe in paying tithes, you are not a member of the church. Huh? You can believe it's better you go to Church of Christ than to be here and believe Church of Christ doctrine. Praise the Lord. So that is where we are. Amen. So get yourselves ready, and then we'll have elections on Sunday next week. As we stand to our feet, shall we bow our heads as we pray? Father, we thank you this morning for your grace, your goodness, your mercy. We thank you for your loving kindness and your tender mercies, Lord. Father, we come this morning once more unworthy, O Father. But Lord, we come by the blood. May that blood speak better things for us today. As we go into the word, Father, take me out of the way. May you speak to your people. Father, open their hearts that they will be good ground to receive the word that will bring forth, Lord Jesus. Help us, Lord, and bless us this morning. Bless the reading of your word, the hearing of it, and the preaching of it to your glory. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen and amen. 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 And so, just to add that the conventions, I've not heard anything from Ivory Coast. And by this time, I don't think there will be any meetings. Amen. Because if they were, they would have announced them by now. Praise the Lord. And so there are meetings in Trinidad. That's for July. And meetings for Germany in August. Amen. So those that want to go to Trinidad and Germany, if you are ready, let us know. Then we can work out, and then you get your visas early. Praise the Lord. But I have to announce it. It's an invitation to the church. So there are meetings in Trinidad and in Germany. Amen. Those who want to go, make yourselves ready and let us know. And then we can do the visa processing and things like that. Amen. So the book of 1 John chapter 3, verse 1 to 3. We're not going to be long today by the grace of God. He said, behold, what manner of love the Father has bestowed upon us, that we should be called the sons of God. Therefore the world knoweth us not, because it knoweth him not. Beloved, now are we the sons of God, and it does not yet appear what we shall be, but we know that when he shall appear, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. You get it now? And every man that has this hope in him purified himself, even as he is pure. Praise God. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading of his word. You may be seated. Amen. So I want to take a title from, amen, the scripture. It said, now are we the sons of God. And I want to take my title today, now are we the sons of God. And a subject, the manifestation of God in his body. Praise the Lord. Now, good to see our friend again, Brother Bernard. God bless you. You are welcome to the house of the Lord. Amen. You see, the world, Satan is so wicked. Are you getting me? And that's why these days I'm slowing down, and I want you to understand who children of God are. Because the devil has made it so easy that once you go to church, you are a child of God. Praise the Lord. And then he comes into the church and perverts it with all kinds of doctrines. Once you speak in tongues, you have the Holy Ghost. Amen. And then people begin to speak in tongues because it's a spirit. Amen. You get, then that spirit possesses you, begin to speak in tongues, and you think that's the Holy Spirit. Amen. But Paul came back and said, though I speak with tongues of men and of angels, without charity, nothing. Praise God. So it goes beyond the gifts. It goes beyond belonging to church. It goes beyond knowing the word. Praise God. The Spirit must come upon that to put you in the body of Christ. Then the Spirit will bear witness with your spirit that you are a son of God. So when the Spirit of God begins to unveil the manifestation of God, then you can say, I'm a son of God. I'm a daughter of God. I am in the body of Christ. Praise God. So this love, Paul John says, it has been bestowed upon us. You may be seated. That we should be called the sons of God. So because the love of God is bestowed upon us, it gives us the right to be called the sons of God. So we must see the love of God in our hearts. Amen. And when we say love of God, it's not love for me. My loving you is you loving God. Praise God. If you love him, you will worship him. If you love him, you will praise him. If you love him, you will pray. If you love him, you will fast. If you love him, you will dedicate your life to the manifestation of God, that this word will become flesh. Hallelujah. Praise God. The love has been bestowed upon us, so we must effect this love. Praise God. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. That we should be called the sons of God. He said, therefore the world knoweth us not. You may be seated. So you can't love, you cannot have this love of God and the world will know you. Are you getting me? Yes, so he tells you that you become an oddball. You become I walk alone. Yes, because you cannot walk with God and walk with the world. The cross before me, the world behind me. You bend the bridges of the world behind you and you pick the cross and walk with Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Because the love is over you. Praise God. So if you love God, amen, which is the love of the Father, you will love the things of God. You will love the word of God. You will love the people of God. So he said, beloved, now are we the sons of God. It does not yet appear what we shall be. Praise God. But you know that the Lord, when he's coming, he does all three. Praise God. At his coming, he does all three. Praise God. Amen. The shout, the voice, the trump. What is it to do? To get you to be like Jesus Christ. So when the Holy Ghost begins to move among the people, at his appearing, we shall be like him. We shall be images of his image, life of his life, spirit of his spirit. Because he's appearing now as the word. Oh, be seated. Praise God. Amen. Are you with me now? He said, when he appears, he said, it does not yet appear what we shall be. But we know that when he shall appear, we shall be like him. For we shall see him as he is. So God is appearing among his children today in the form of the Holy Spirit. And that Spirit will teach you all things. It will teach you how to live as a Christian, talk as a Christian, manifest your life, your desires will be like a Christian. He's appearing now in the word, by the Spirit, bringing us to the word image of himself. You may be seated. Praise God. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. So beloved, amen, we shall see him as he is. And every man that has this hope, we have the hope that we are waiting for the coming of the Lord. We have this hope. Therefore, we must what? Purify ourselves. Huh? We've got to purify ourselves. It means that we've got to change our ways. We've got to repent. We've got to come in and be washed by the blood of Jesus Christ. So we can't remain how we were. We've got to purify ourselves because we have a hope that he's coming. Praise God. And when he comes physically to pick us out of here, we shall appear like him because we have already been formed into his image by the word. and the word is in us. If my word is in you and you in my word. He said, if you abide in me and my word abide in you, then you can ask what you will. Then you can speak like Adam. You can speak like Elijah. You can speak like the prophets of old, and it shall be done unto you. Why? Because the word is abiding in you. Praise God. We shall be like him. Praise God. Amen. Hallelujah. So this is not for the bishop. This is not for the pastor. This is for everyone that is baptized into the body. We must see the manifestation of God in your life. There's got to be a manifestation of God. Praise God. You may be seated. Amen. We're not going to be long. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. He said, these signs shall follow them that believe. Now, we are not waiting for the millennium to manifest the miracles. Because in the millennium, it will not be your flesh. In the millennium, you will not need to be healed. Because there won't be sickness there. There won't be cripples there. There won't be diabetes there. There won't be blood pressure there. So right now, we need the signs, the wonders, the miracles. Because we are in this flesh. The flesh gets sick. The flesh gets high blood pressure. It gets heart diseases. But God put power in the church to deliver the body right now. Praise God. So we are not waiting for the manifestation of God in the millennium. No, we don't need that there. Because Jesus will be the light. There will be no darkness there. There will be no night there. He will be the light that will lighten up every spirit. Praise God. Satan will not be there. Satan is sickness. Demon powers are sickness. They wouldn't be there. So we need the signs right now. We need the manifestation of God right now. Oh, come on, sons of God. It's now that you need to prove who you are. Oh, glory. Glory to God. Amen. Sons of God, we need to prove who we are. We are the sons of God. Hallelujah. When the Holy Ghost came upon them, the people knew that this was different people. They knew that they had been with Jesus Christ. Because when Jesus was on the earth, he was healing the sick. He was raising the dead. He was opening the blind eye. So when Jesus left and the Spirit came upon the children, the apostles, they knew that these people had been with Jesus Christ. Because Peter was like he was. Are you getting me now? Peter healed the sick. Peter, the lame man, looked at him and said, silver and gold I don't have. What I have, I give to you. What did he have? He had Christ in him. He had power in him. He was given power to become the Son of God. So he said, silver and gold I don't have. Such as I have, I give to you in the name of Jesus Christ. Rise up and walk. We are to come to that. This is the time for the manifestation of the sons of God. Praise him. We are not sons of God by belonging to church. We are sons of God by the manifestation of the Spirit. Because as many as are led by the Spirit, they are the sons of God. Led by the Spirit. Moved by the Spirit. Praise God. Amen. We've got to be sons by the Spirit. Oh, praise God. Amen. You may be seated. Amen. Amen. So we don't need miracles in the millennium. So don't wait when I get in the millennium. No, we don't need that time. We will cast you out. Yes, amen. Because there won't be demons there. So what miracle are you performing? In the name of Jesus, what are you casting out there? Because there it will be the justified. Yes, it will be the sanctified. It will be the filled, the saved, the ransomed, the redeemed of Christ will be there in the millennium. When all the demons would have been paid out, everything would have been bent out, we will return back here and we'll reign with him as kings and priests. Don't be no need for miracle. Because we will be the very miracle of his power. That we were sick but he healed us. We were lost but he redeemed us. We will be the very testimony of the healing, saving power of Christ. But right now, we must be the sons of God. Now we must be the sons of God. Maybe see that. Amen. So God sent us a prophet, not to confuse the people. We must preach for the people to understand. Are you getting it? Jesus said, blessed are the poor. What? How big was that to understand? Blessed are they who hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled. That was Christ Almighty. Huh? The giver of revelation. But his message was so simple, till the common man held him gladly. Today we will preach and confuse the people and confuse ourselves. Divine mysteries. But God needs to see power in the church. That's what the word is to do. Bring down Christ. The same yesterday, today, and forever. Praise God. Amen. Oh, we are going to go into things, man. The time for demon powers are over. We will cast them out. We will unveil this devil, these supernatural spirits. We will unveil them and bring down God hidden in simplicity and revealing himself in simplicity. Give me the word. What is the word? All those that believe, to them he gave them power to become the sons of God. You must believe the word in order to receive power to become a son of God. When you become a son of God, you are candidates of the Holy Spirit. You must be candidates of the Holy Spirit. Praise God, amen. Because without the Holy Ghost baptism, you cannot come into the body of Christ. Are you getting me now? You must get the Holy Ghost baptism. That is what baptizes you into the body of Christ. Not mysteries. Not who is your pastor. Not my pastor can preach deep things. What deep things? Deep things, and Satan is making a bed in your heart with deep demons. Are you getting me now? Be seated. Because we have watered down this message by hiding under mysteries. And these mysteries fly over the life of the people. Because the devil is there. Yeah, preach mysteries. And the people, hey, ho, ha. But these demons have settled permanent residence. They've got resident permits. Some have got indefinite stay. Are you getting me now? And then these divine mysteries are shim, shim. They are not entering. They are just passing over the head of the people. Till in the message, you can talk about adultery in the church. Are you getting me? Fornication there is free for all. Can't be the message of God. Can't be the church of God. Because he who has this hope purified what? Himself. Christ ain't coming for a dirty bride. He ain't coming for a filthy church. He is coming for those that have purified themselves. Then when we are here, then we can say, we are now the sons of God. Are you getting me now? Then the church is holy, justified, sanctified. Then we are candidates for the filling of the Holy Spirit. Then God is now ready to stamp his authority. That is my son. That is my daughter that has sanctified themselves, ready for me to fill them. Then the Spirit can pour itself into you, that he can use you. The purpose of the Holy Ghost coming is God to use us. Are you following me now? Be seated. The purpose of the Holy Ghost coming into anybody is for God to use you. God can't put the Holy Ghost in you to be sinning. Are you getting it? God can't put the Holy Ghost in you not to be a Christian that cannot pray. If you have the Holy Ghost, you will pray. You will love to pray. If you have the Spirit, you will love to come to church. You love to worship God at every given opportunity. You will love to serve Him in spirit and in truth. Because he said, in the last days, the love of many shall wax cold. It's love of many, not sons of God. Sons of God will love to worship Him. And it's getting hard. Yeah, it's going to get harder. But the Bible says it's going to get hard and hard and hard and harder. Praise God, amen. But sons of God will worship Him more and more and more and more. They will love Him more and more and more and more. Because the love of God will grow richer and richer and richer and richer in the heart of sons of God. They will love Him. They will love His. They will love to praise Him. They will love to live for Him. They will love to live His life. Manifest the word, sons of God. We've got to be sons of God. When you are there and then the wind that is blowing, the wind of no praise, the wind of backsliding blows over you, then you find excuses. There is no excuses with the Holy Ghost. Is there? Is there? Brother said, when the Holy Ghost, that's what the Holy Ghost was given for. There is no excuses with the Holy Ghost. Though He slay me, yet will I serve Him. That's the Son of God. Amen. Thank God, the prophet said there is churches. There is bride. But there's coming forth one. We're not talking about spoken word churches. We're not talking about spoken word church. I belong to spoken word church. Yes, but I want to be in the bride. Where I will live the word. I will manifest the word. I will take the trial. I will stand there and be filled with the Spirit. We're not talking about fundamental preaching. If it is fundamental preaching, Assemblies of God can preach better. Pentecost can preach better. Methodists can preach better. Church of Christ can preach better. Deeper Life can preach better. But we are talking about a called out group, a bride of Jesus Christ, living the life, demonstrating Christ, the same yesterday, today, and forever, under their prophet, under their messenger. They will be the final voice to the final age with the word for their day, a living body of Christ manifesting the promises. That's what we are looking for. Oh, praise God, amen. We've got to be sons of God, amen. Praise be the name of the Lord, amen. Hallelujah. Sons of God, we've got to realize who we are. We are not here tossed to and fro by every wind of doctrine. When I was a child, I spoke as a child. Amen. I thought as a child. But when I became a man, a mature son, praise God, I put away childish things. Amen. I can't be tired. I can't be sick. I must be at the post of duty. That's why a son of God should talk. That's how a son of God lives. Why? Because I was put here for a purpose, to worship the Father, to bring glory to His name. So whatever we do, it must bring glory and honor to Christ. Sons of God. Praise God, amen. You may be seated. Amen. So we have to start looking for the manifestation of God in our midst. We need the healing. We need the deliverance. We need the prayer warriors. Now, when they say the prayer warriors are going to pray, hell will be shaken. Satan will check all his demons. Who is not here? You better come back before you are destroyed. Because these prayer warriors are going to prayer. That means that you are fighters in the spirit. No prayer warrior can't pray 5 minutes. You better dissolve that prayer warrior thing. Are you getting me? Some people say we should do all night prayer. Just laugh. All night prayer. When we start, maybe the first all night, people will be happy. The next all night, people come here. Let's pray. People will turn and kneel down, put their head on the chair and sleep. 1 hour prayer. Let us pray. Knees on the chair. Brother, when you raise your hands, it's a sign of what? Victory. So every son of God, pray with your hand of victory. Lord, I thank you. Lord, I bless you. 1 hour, you can't raise your hand and pray. Sons of God, sons of God. We are bride. We are going to rapture. Rapture. In heaven, there's only worship. In heaven, there's only praise. So you don't want to praise. You don't want to worship. Brother, say, forget it. You won't be there. Because heaven is not to sleep. There's no bed there. Oh, but we are going to have our own mansion with the street paved with gold. Hey, gold. There's no sleeping there. Because we sleep in this flesh. Huh? There's no death there. Sleep is a sign of death. So the proverb in their local language, they say, if you want to see death, go and taste what? Sleep. Is it not true? The only thing is that when you are not dead, the next day you wake up. Something makes you to get up. But when you are sleeping, you are dead. Are you getting it? Then the next morning, because there's still life, you wake up from the dead. But when the life is over, you sleep and sleep through. They tap you, no movement. You are actually now dead. In heaven, that process is not there. In heaven, it is holy, 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 holy unto the Lord God Almighty. Amen. We will tell, look, before we start talking to all the brothers of their experiences to come down to Adam. So Adam, tell me, what power made you follow Eve? Me, I want to ask him that question. After God created in his image, Adam will say, my brother, it is grace. Then we'll start singing, it is grace, oh grace. That's how heaven is going to be. If your idea is that heaven now, I'm going to be driving big car, eating big, big food, we'll not be eating food in heaven. Are you getting me? There will not be food to eat in heaven. Lord, I thank you. I'm suffering now. I know I'll eat all the big chicken in heaven. You won't get there. There's no chicken there. So if you are not eating your chicken now, thank God you are not eating now. But don't pray that you eat it there. There won't be death there. So which chicken will you slaughter there to kill and eat? We are going to be spirit beings there because this mortal must put on immortality. Yes, so you are not going in your flesh. You are not going in your thinking. You are not going. You are going in the spirit and power of Jesus Christ. So all the chicken you want to eat is here now, 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 now. So get the power to create, to command that chicken now. If you want to eat your chicken, get that power now. But in there is going to be joy unspeakable and full of glory. Are you getting me now? So now we are the sons of God. We must see the manifestation of God now. There, what are you going to manifest? He will be there. No spirit moves. Because we are all going to be subjects of him. Praise God. And he will have already achieved what he wants the body to achieve on the earth. Praise God. So we are proving that what he did, we are doing. But when we get there, we can't do nothing. We have overcome. There's no demon to cast out there. There's no principality to overcome. It will just be the love of God. The peace of God. The joy of God. The joy unspeakable and full of glory. So right now, let us strive. Do everything we can to become sons of God right now. Don't be satisfied of church. We must be sons of God. You may be seated. Praise God. Amen. 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 Brother, now what think ye of Christ? Paragraph 24. He said, now we are in that body of Jesus Christ. And while we are in there, we've accepted his punishment in our stead. So while we are here today, like Sunday school this morning, we rejected Barabbas and we accepted Christ. Are you getting me? We are saying, release Christ to us. We don't want Barabbas. But the world wanted Barabbas. And he gave them what? Barabbas. So all the stealing and all the wickedness and all the injustices is a Barabbas spirit upon them. And yet all those corrupt officials, they are in church this morning, receiving word, calling themselves Christians. But yet, no honesty, no integrity. Why? No spirit. So he's not just going to church and doing a ritual. Praise God. But the spirit must be in you to quicken your mortal body. How can Christ, praise God, be in you and you be a corrupt official? How can that be? At your workplace, it's 100. Then you add another 0 to make it 1,000. How can that be Christ? How can that be Christ? Christ is holy. Christ is righteous. And if the fear of God is the beginning of what? Wisdom. So if the fear of God is in everybody that goes to church today, the countries will not be where they are. Everybody wants to be a politician because that's the easiest way to make money. God, this government comes and corrupts itself. The next government cannot prosecute them. Because when they come, they'll do the same. So it's one go, one come. It's 8 years. You have chopped for 8 years. Go. I also come and chop for 8 years. So they don't care the loans they are piling on the citizens. They don't care. How can that be Christ? And they are all sitting in church this morning. And the same corrupt preachers are preaching to them. Oh, there's no judgment in politics. If politics is a human affair. God does not relate himself in things of human beings. So therefore, when we do all that and go, there's no judgment. Who told you? Every action of our life will be, we will pay for it. Because the Bible says, whatever you sow, that is what you want. You will reap. So all those corrupt people, there's a hell and there's a heaven. Children of God go to heaven. Children of Satan go to hell. So when you are stealing, that is not God. When you are corrupting yourself, that is not God. Praise God. And as a citizen of the country, you must also do your civic responsibilities. You can't be a good citizen and you be stealing illegal connection. You can't be a child of God and doing illegal connection. The Holy Ghost can come into you with illegal connections in your homes. Are you hearing me now? Oh, you want to be a son of God? You've got to purify yourself. Sons of God, you will live above reproach. You want to enjoy what you are not paying for. You are a thief. Thou shalt not what? Thou shalt not steal. Thou shalt not steal. A wee barao. Go and tamper with your meter, then it's not reading as you and you are enjoying it. No demon can hold my body. You lie. When the rapture is going, illegal connection will pull your leg back. I am here with you. Sons of God, look, you must live. The world know it as not. The world don't know us. So when they are doing their illegal connection, you are not part of it. You are a son of God. Don't party yourself with the world. The world don't know you with that. Are you getting me now?
Yes.
I had a driver who was driving the truck, and I rented a place for him. But this guy drinks alcohol. And he tried to be smart. Because he knows I won't countenance such a thing. Because I warned him, the day I'll catch you drinking, that day your job is finished. So you be smart. Do it then. Then the landlord of the house I rented for him asked the son, "This guy that has come to take this room, are you aware the guy drinks?" He said, "Well, I haven't seen him drinking." And I like the answer the son gave to the father. He said, "I haven't seen him drinking." He said, "But if he really drinks, the man that he's working with, he won't last with him." Are you getting me? Yeah. Then when I paid him, he went and drank and didn't come to work. I had to drive the car myself. He came and was swagging past me like, because he was drunk. The manifestation will be the one, the interpretation. Nobody needs to point a finger at you. Your own life will manifest what seed is there. And what seed is there is the spirit, will show the spirit that is anointing you.
Yes, sir.
The 2 days he didn't come to work. The third day he got said, "What work? What work?" I sacked myself. He himself sacked himself. Why? Because he knew that he had been caught red-handed. And sons of God, people must bear witness of our spirit. Oh, if it is this brother, no, you can't get him there. Because the world knoweth us not with those things. They could not attack Christ. Pilate said, "Praise God, amen. I am washing my hands of this innocent and just man." Pilate declared that Christ was a just man. Though the people said crucify him, but he knew that I am innocent of the blood of this just man. We, the bride, we must be known like Christ was known. If it is love, the love of God must be there. If it is mercy, we must have mercy. If it is compassion, we must have a compassion. But if it is righteousness, we must have what? Righteousness. Don't put the message as a covering. Once you are in the message, we are done. You haven't started. The message is not a license. Somebody's a license to kill. It's not a license to misbehave. The message is a license to prove God in your life, God in your neighborhood, God in the place of work. That is what the message is to you. So you must manifest this God to the world. Then this will all men know that you are my what? Disciples.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
We are into that body of Christ. While we are here, we've accepted his punishment in our stead, knowing no sin. He knowing no sin, yet was made sin for us. And he bore our sickness. He bore our sins. We come into him. We are free from this judgment. Are you getting it? God cannot justly judge me or you the second time if he's already accepted us in Christ Jesus. He punished his own son for us. How can he punish us when he has already had Christ paid for our price? So if you know that your sins have been paid for, how will you go and sin again? So that Christ will be crucified a second time. Huh? Illegal connections. Water bill, illegal. Go and remove the meter. Be bypassing the water. Look, the Holy Ghost can't come. And then you must repent and confess. Because when confessing is confessed, so you must take yourself to the VRA. I've come to confess. In fact, I did illegal connection for 8 months. I'm sorry. I want you to come and correct it. That's confessed sin. Are you hearing? No, I'm helping you to understand, because you must receive the Holy Ghost. These are the things people do and cut God off of them. Ghana Water Company, I did bypass of my meter. I'm sorry. I've come to confess. Your God will go before you and soften the heart of that officer. He said, I've never seen a people like this. Which church do you attend? Your life will challenge them. God, it won't be normal. They all do it anyway. So for you to come and confess, they will come and correct it and say, don't do it again. Then God will be pleased. Then he says, he that stole, steal no more. Then he has wiped off that one. But I don't do it when it's convenient for you. But God understands. God don't understand nothing. Whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are holy, if there be any virtue, think on these things. That's how the Holy Ghost comes. That's how you are made a son. You are made a daughter. That's how you manifest God in this dying world. I don't know why I'm here, but praise God. The Spirit wants to teach you something. You want to be a son of God? You've got to come purified. Are you getting me now? Praise God. Amen. So the prophet said, amen. Now, in the second coming of Christ, the second coming of the Lord, paragraph 20. Now, we have different religions. People are doing religion. The finance minister will come and quote Bible. Before anything, he will come with white and quote Bible like a Christian. That man is not a Christian. He hasn't found Christ yet. Christ don't lie. And any son of God should not what? Lie. Let your yea be yea and your nay be nay. Swear by no other heaven, neither in heaven nor on the earth. But let your yea be yea and your nay be nay. By their fruits, the Bible says, we shall know them. So your life tells who you are. Not your outward appearance. You can wear all the white and quote Genesis to Revelation. But if the word that you quote doesn't match your life, there's another spirit on you. Are you hearing me now? Yes. So Christianity is not wearing white and quoting Bible. Christianity is living the Bible. Yes. These our leaders, I don't think they think of hell. They think they will just do whatever they want to do, die and go to heaven. There's no heaven for such characters. Hell is waiting. All those who that do wickedly shall burn. It shall leave them neither root nor branch. The politicians, they better think of life after all the corruption they will amass. Because there's hell waiting to reward them. And sons of God, there's a heaven waiting to reward you. So, and each of them have their life patterns. So don't pattern yourself after the world and expect to end up in heaven. Don't pattern yourself after heaven and expect to end up in hell. They don't work that way. You make your preparation now. So if you have been given the privilege to be a minister, to serve the people, serve them with all sincerity, all honesty. Because every dishonest act will be rewarded. Whatever you sow, that is what you will reap. All the CEOs and all the board chairmen, they think they've just got, it's our time to get it. Yeah, it's your time. God gave the resources to the nation for his people. So there's coming for judgment. There's coming for judgment, and judgment simply means what? Reward. Judgment is not all the time negative. When you take your case to court, you expect to win or to what? To lose. And on the day it is decided, that is what? Judgment day. And when you win, the victory is judgment. But you are victorious. So there's a judgment day coming. Praise God. For those that will make heaven and those that will make hell. Sons of God are going to rejoice at that day. Praise God, because you have made yourself ready to escape the judgment of corruption. You have overcome the corruption that is in the world through lust. You don't lust after the things. You don't lust after the world. You don't lust after the things of the world. You have overcome them. Separated yourself. Praise God, amen. So when he comes, you would have purified yourself. So we have different religions. Are you a Christian? A Methodist. That's a Methodist religion. Yes, and when all the evil is even done worse than it was then, those preachers, hireling preachers, don't represent God or the kingdom of God. Synagogues of Satan they are, the Bible said, transforming themselves into angels of light. Satan himself has transformed himself into angels of light. And his ministers, Satan has got ministers. That's why all these politicians are paying heavily to these false anointed devils in this day to prophesy. You will win this. You will win that. God has revealed nothing. God will never do anything to my glory. He will do everything to his glory. What has the glory of God to do with a criminal politician that God will vindicate to any man of God? Bunch of murderers. If you know the things they do to get to where they are, you will not want to envy them one day of your life. All kind of fetish and occultic spirits. Don't ever stay as a son of God. Go after the things of God. But these people, they will stand the judgment. Because God has given them opportunity to hear the word. But they turn it down and said, give us Barabbas. They've got Barabbas. But sons of God. Oh, give me Jesus. Give me Jesus. Give me Jesus. He died for me. He paid the price. Amen. And I'm going to rise with him in power, in spirit, to prove to this dying world that there's a son of God on the earth. Praise be the name of the Lord. So we have different religion. We have different motives, different theologies. But our Christian religion is based solemnly upon the death, burial, and resurrection. And the second coming of the Lord is an important question. Our Christian belief is based on the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ. And the second coming. So it's not enough to know that he died. It's not enough to know that he was buried, he rose. But he is coming. And any man that has this hope purified what? Himself. God, he's coming. His coming means a lot. It means I must prepare myself. I must prepare my body. I must prepare my spirit for his coming. You may be seated. Amen. Oh, and as we are now approaching, Brother said, to my most sincere thoughts, we are now living in the shadows of his second coming. He said, there shall be what? Perilous time shall come. Are they not here? Look, this Russia-Ukraine war, forget it. Anybody that tells you that it's coming is not coming to nowhere. Huh? Because there will be wars and rumors of war. Christ is coming. This world must burn as an oven. There's got to be an anointed demon to spark that fire. Sons of God must also spark the coming of the Lord. we must charge to a level that Christ can't sit no more. He will appear and pick us out of here. We must charge. Just as these demon politicians are charging, corrupting the world everywhere, we must also get on the charge for the coming of the Lord. We don't belong to this world. We don't belong here. I am not a Ghanaian. I come from God and I'm going back to God. That is where I belong. We must charge to get out of here. Oh, praise God. Amen. Charge to get out of here. Amen. Hallelujah. We are living in the very shadows of his second coming. There, to my way of seeing it by the light of the scripture, there is not one hope left for the church outside the coming of the Lord. They are persecuting the church. You may be seeing it. In England, there's a law. Even your thoughts can be prosecuted in court. Does that make sense? How do you know what I'm thinking? But as we are here in church, we are thinking against homosexuals. We are thinking against gays and lesbians. So therefore, we can be prosecuted as a church. So there's no hope for the church. That is why they all have to sign to the World Council of Churches. Because those Council of Churches are corrupted by Satan himself. Till they can marry gay and lesbians. God forbid, let them step foot here. That day, the way Jesus took a cane and beat them out of the temple, that day, they will see punches they've never seen in their life. If you will not be delivered spiritually, you'll be cast out physically. No gay and lesbian will step foot in this church. They are devils. They need to repent and be saved. Don't care where they come from. Don't care CNN what they say. These are devils that the Bible said they will be here. They are here, but sons of God too are here to prove to these devils that Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Don't care about these principalities. Praise God, amen. Praise God. Oh, we are living it. When you see these demon powers, as it was in the days of Sodom, so shall it be in the day when the Son of Man is revealed. He has been revealed in my day as the Word and Spirit. Lesbians and gay, whatever, they can rise, but the power of the church is also rising to prove that sons of God are still on this earth. When we leave, they will find out that their laws are nothing but cannon fodder for fire. Fire will burn them and their laws. And we'll see what will save them then. They have the opportunity to repent and accept this gospel of Jesus Christ and be saved, reject it, and be damned. There's going to be a manifestation of God. Praise God, amen. Amen. The world, Brother Brown said, is in this wild pandemonium, is in this wild pandemonic condition, has gone completely out of control. 1957, Ghana Independence Day, 66 years ago. Brother Brown said, the world in this pandemonic condition has gone completely out of control. Is it out of control? Son of God speaking by prophecy. This is what we talk about, prophecy. When you speak under the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, not God has shown me who will be flag bearer. Nonsense. That's not why you are put there to be a preacher. That's not a prophetic gift. This is a prophetic gift. The world in its wild pandemonic condition has got completely out of control of every man-made organization in the world. Kings cannot hold their subjects no more. Is it happening? Kings cannot hold their subjects. What is happening in Boko? Kings cannot hold their subjects anymore. Are you getting it now? Neither can dictators hold their subjects anymore. Democracy cannot hold its subjects anymore. There is no hope left but the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. No party will make Ghana better. MPP West, NDC West, no party will come and this country will get back better. They are all the same. They're all coming to corrupt themselves and make themselves rich. The only thing that will save this world is the second coming of Jesus Christ. To put everything to a hush. Stop the devils. Stop the politicians. Stop the corrupt people. Fire, burn all. Fire will settle the question. But sons of God, you must get yourself ready. Purify yourselves to get out before that fire strikes. So don't get comfortable with this world, because the world knew not Christ. You can't be in school and comfortable with the world. You can't be at the workplace and comfortable with the world. The world must not know you. Because they didn't know Christ. Are you following me now? We must be. Now we are the sons of God. Nothing left but for the coming of the Lord. It is now one of the most horrible times for the unbelief. For the unbelief and sinner that he has ever witnessed. These people, they will see what they've never seen. France and all their exploitation of Africa. They think they are enjoying. Fire will come. This fire is not by no terrorists. If they can catch God and bring him to the ICC, they should go and catch him there. Fire will come. All the injustices these colonial masters have perpetuated, America and all the rest of them, No problem. Fire is coming. And this fire is not going to be a terrorist group. God, the righteous judge, will settle all their questions. So they can bring whatever they want to bring on Africa and use their superior weapons to do whatever they want to do. There is coming a day. Fire will settle everything. But what you need to do is to get yourself ready so that you are not condemned with them. How pitiful it will be after they have corrupted themselves and enjoyed the world that you haven't enjoyed with them. Then you end up the same with them. Get yourself ready. But no one is going unpunished. Don't care who you are. All the kings of England and the queens of England, I wish God could give them 1 minute to speak back to their people. Then they would tell them, this creation of God, don't play with them. God created the white man, created the black man, gave man equal opportunity to live where he has placed you and enjoy. If you want to come together and do trade, let the trade be fair. Not one exploit the other for the good of the other one. You will pay for it. Because every man will reap what they sow. So those of you doing your business, do your business right. Do it what? Don't cut corners. Praise God. Amen. It's now one of the most horrible times for the unbelief and sinner that he has ever witnessed, because the doom time is close at hand. Doom. This one is not terrorist. This is not Al-Qaeda or ISIS. No, this is doom time. God himself has his clock. When he turned it, doom time, fire, boom. You can have all the atomic weapon. It can't stop it. Hey, you can have all your anti-air missile, what. It will blast that one off. Wherever you go, underground bunker, it will uproot you out. So let no man think that he's wise. God will find you wherever you are. The doom time is close at hand, and it is the most blessed time for the believer. Oh, we are rejoicing. I'm rejoicing night and day as I walk the narrow way. For the comforter abides with me. We're not afraid. No fire is coming here. Because listen, we don't belong to their political system. We belong to another economy, which is the economy of God. So we are here as what? Investigating angels. Spying out the land. Telling the Lord the cup of the Amorites is full. Send down the fire. God's church is the power that is shaking this hour. The day of redemption is nigh. Sons of God, rise up to your occasion. Praise God. It's the most blessed time for the believer, for his redemption is at hand. But man said there is two factions in this earth tonight, the believer and the unbeliever. The one the Lord is coming to receive, and the one the Lord is coming to condemn at his coming. He will bless one and will curse the other at his appearing. Are you getting me now? God, listen to me. Be seated. People can make noise and give order. I order you into prison. I'm judge. I order you into prison. As if he's somebody. God is coming to order those out of prison. Prison of this hardship they put us in. God is coming to usher us out into the blessed presence of his Holy Spirit. And put on the wrath. He will bless you and will curse the other. That is God. That time they should take their jet fighters and fly to the sky to go and face God. That their international station, it will fall down like a rat. Boom. Because they will all come back and face judgment. They are building space. They are going to Mars. All their satellites will drop back on the earth. Time is over. It's time for judgment. The higher scientist will know then that there's a need for God. But it will be too late. He's coming to bless one and will curse the other at his appearing. It was such a great thing to John the Revelator at the Isle of Patmos that when he saw the preview of the coming of the Lord, when he saw the curses that rested upon the unbeliever and the blessings that rested on the believer, he screamed out, "Even so, come Lord Jesus." He's so thrilled his heart after all he had seen the events before his coming. He screamed, "Even so, come Lord Jesus." And when the whole church age has been passed, amen, in his view, and he's seen everything in major, the way it would happen, then he screamed, "Come Lord Jesus." It must be a glorious thing that the coming of the Lord draws near at hand. We must be crying out, "Even so, come Lord Jesus." We are tired of the corruption. We are tired of the evil. We are tired of the injustices in this world. Lord, come. It's only when Jesus comes that these people will realize that they should have really been servants and not lords. Believer, that's the time those that will miss the rapture will know I should have been serious with my Christian life. I should have prayed. I should have sought the Holy Ghost. But I was there listening to divine hidden mysteries. I was belonging to groups and camps in the message. Fire is coming for all that nonsense. Only those that receive the mark will be there. Tie not those with the mark. Any other person without the mark, utterly kill and destroy. It's coming. That is what from the end time sign, verse chapter paragraph 12. That is what the bride has done with the world. United with the world with her creed and things, and deny the word of God, saying the days of miracle is past. There's no such thing as the baptism of the Holy Ghost. And where she at now? Divorced. Who? The bride. Divorced. I take what my pastor say. Apart from that, no other pastor. Divorced. What the Spirit saith unto the what? Churches. Let him that are not hear. Let him what? Let him hear what the Spirit is saying unto. Not what your pastor is saying. Your pastor might be growing a church, But God ain't coming for that church. God is coming for a bride of his word. That's where we must be as we get ready to close up. Amen. Jesus' bride had done the same thing that Jehovah's bride did, and the same thing that Adam's bride did. Yes, exactly. The Bible said, at the mouth of three witnesses, let every word be established. There's three churches, three brides, all of them done the same thing. So Adam's bride, corrupted. Jehovah's bride, corrupted. Jesus' bride, corrupted. All divorced. So the church has become a dancing place for demons. Every cage of every foul spirit. Every hateful and unclean bed. And we think that's Catholic is here too. That's why people do the sins they still do and have boldness to still walk into the presence and sit down. I'm in church today. Are you getting me now? Because divorced. But listen. But in the face of all that, God had to allow that in order for individuals to be chosen, to be called, to be pulled out. But in the face of all that, there is a real bride that God is bringing forth. In the midst of all this, there's this one bride there, maybe one in the corner here, one there. Maybe here, just two people. But they are bride. In the midst of all that, there is a real bride that God is bringing forth. Has a little bit out of each. So there's a little bit out of this church. There's a little bride out of here. The rest will just play church. The rest will just come. I mean, the message. The rest will just live anyhow. We are not seeing anything. They say if you do this, judgment will strike you. Nothing has happened. Oh, they are lying. Nothing like that. I can enjoy myself. In the midst of all that, there is a real bride. And God has a little bit out of each. Each time there's been a reformation, there's been so much of the word spread forth. And each generation gets its time. There will be a man of God come along that will strike fire with God, and there will be a great revival sweep the land. And what happens? Immediately after they take that man's idea and denominate it, it brings in creed and mix with it. And she dies and never rises again. Are you getting it? Jesus Christ was the person. So when that happens, God sent a prophet. We believe God sent a prophet. If you are outside the message, you come and say, we agree, denominate. Settle down, dead. And think that because I'm in the message, I have made it. All that you love and all that ever loved you will be there. Even if I don't believe, my father believes. All that you love, my father's love will bring me. Is that so? My brother's love will bring me. My sister's love will bring me. My father and mother's love will bring me. It doesn't work like that. Every one of us must seek our salvation with fear and trembling.
Amen. Yes, sir.
Are you getting it?
Amen.
So, from the indictment, and I'm done. Jesus Christ was the person, man, God, hallelujah. He was the manifestation of God. He was God in a body form to reflect the word of God for that age. To make that age see God's promises for that age. And the Holy Spirit is the same today. It is the Spirit of God upon the written word. Are you getting me now? So look, I'm in the message. No, let the Spirit of God on the written word. Spirit of God on the written word. What is he doing? Trying to find somebody to reflect itself to this age. So the message is the Holy Ghost upon the message, trying to find somebody to reflect the message to this world. That is what we are today. the Holy Spirit upon the message of Malachi 4 to produce sons and daughters of God that will reflect that message to this age. That is what we're looking for. That is what we are talking about. That's what the church is all about. That is what the message is all about. The Spirit on the written word trying to find somebody to reflect itself to this age. Praise God, to prove that it's the same yesterday, today, and forever. St. John 14:12, the works that I do shall you do also. Jesus Christ, the same yesterday, today, and forever. See? That is what the Spirit is here to do. Are you getting it? The Spirit is here to come on the written word. To find somebody that will reflect the word for today. Then we can say you are a son of God. Then you can say, now are we sons of God, when the Bible can be seen in your flesh. You are in the office. These ones know that as for this guy, corrupt matters, don't take it to him, because he won't accept it. He won't accept it. Why? The Spirit has found you that you can reflect the word. Then they can say, truly, this is a Christian. Now are we the sons of God. What for? For the manifestation of God. The Spirit wanting to. There's revival going on. What is it? It's a sowing. Be seated. I'm done. It's a sowing. That's from the end time sign seed, paragraph 64. There's a revival going on. What is it? It's a sowing. You don't hear very much about Billy Graham no more, do you? What about Oral? What about the rest of them? You know the great revival fire is not burning. What is it? It's the end time seed sign. If you have all the music, why are we not seeing the power? There is the end time seed sign. The word has been sown. The word has been sown. You don't hear Billy Graham and Oral Roberts anymore. They are all seeds that have been what? Sown. What is it? Denomination will reap denomination. You pick these people and you sit down with them and you take them through the Bible. My church. It's a seed that has been sown. They can't see it. But the Bible says, come out of her, my people. The same Bible that you say, come out of her, because these denominations are going down to hell. God has got his children there, but they will come out. But majority of the people, denomination will read denomination. What make them confederate themselves together? But the word of God has been sowed also. Thank God the word has been sowed in the heart of God's children. And they will go by the Spirit. They will withhold themselves from the world. They will stay true to the Bible. The fear of God will be in their lives. Evil can't come near them. Why? The word of God has been sown. And the word of God has been sown also. And when the Spirit of God begins to fall, the word of God will live in the people. Are you getting me now? So the prophet had to come and sow the word. But don't be in a hurry. The Spirit is about to fall. When it falls, like the rain, it's about rainy season, all the grass will begin to creep. All the thorns and everything will come up. Why? It's the rain. So when the Holy Ghost falls, the people will manifest what is in them. They will manifest the word. And the evil will also manifest what is in them. The evil. By the same Spirit. Are you following me now? Now, beloved, we are the sons of God. Let me close out. Praise God. But the word of God has been sown also, and when the Spirit of God begins to fall, the word of God will live in the people. And the false bride that is committed adultery out there and brought herself into Christ and sold out her birthright will reap what? A confederation of churches. That time they begin to leave. One by one they will go. I'm leaving. What is it? The false branch. It's there now. And the confederation of churches. No, go back to the other one, man. Before this. Let me nail it down. And the false bride is what? A bride. And the false, and that false bride that is committed adultery out there and brought herself into Crete and sold out her birthright will reap what? Yes? A confederation of churches. Not that they will backslide. I don't believe the message. No, they will pack the Bible said they will pack their papers to the next church. That's what they are reaping now. A confederation of what? Churches. We are also in the message. That's to be bent, that's to be bound and bent like the thorns and the thistles. But where the word of God has been sowed into the people's heart. Hallelujah. That's why I'm sowing the word here. Not sowing no creed. Not sowing no message confederation. Will reap a bride for Christ as certain as I am standing here. That's a prophecy over this church. God is going to reap a bride for this, for Christ. Praise God, amen. But where the word of God has been sown into the heart of the people, we have to sow this word of God into your heart in order for you to reap. Praise God. It will reap a bride for Christ as certain as I am standing here. End time signs. What is the matter with the church of God? What is the matter with us? What is the matter with the Baptists, you Presbyterians, Assemblies of God, Jesus only, all the rest of you? What is the matter? What is the matter with us? Can't you see the seed? Be careful what kind of seed you are taking into the womb of your heart. Be careful. What kind of a seed you are taking into your heart? That's why the prophet came back. Be seated. And nail down everything. Showed us the blue. And the prophet said, he brings the blueprint. God has a blueprint. That's why he laid out the church order. Church order and everything. Are you getting me now? Huh. It's a wet seed. You go to a lot of churches in the middle, no order. Is it not part of the word? But brother said, we believe in apostolic what? Church. But we are all in the message. Be careful what kind of a seed you are taking into your womb, the womb of your heart. Don't you take creeds, take the word. They are just shouting, but the word says, make a joyful noise unto the Lord. But the brother said, worship precedes the word, the Holy Spirit. He said, the Antichrist spirit is that spirit that comes in to defile the church. Make it lukewarm, cold, dead, and formal. It's a church preaching God sent the prophet. But it is what? And it has an Antichrist spirit. Are you following me now? Three Hebrew children. We will not bow. Oh, you think there will be a physical fire today? No, you too, you must stand and testify. I won't bow. Yes, sir. But what are you not bowing to? You won't bow to creed, but you will stay with the word. They've been talking so much about the latter rain. No disregard for our latter rain, brethren, but that is not latter rain. If the latter rain would have been here, the power of God would have struck that thing and should have swept away the world. The latter rain is fixing to come. The word has been sown, but the latter rain is coming on the word. So don't think that fire must just come now. No, it's coming. But the word must get into you, bit by bit by bit by bit by bit. When it is full, When that word is in the bride, latter rain, shim, bride, explode. It's coming now. Get the word into you. The rain will come in its time and in its season. Then you will see the power of God rise in the church. The latter rain is fixing to come. What is the matter? The church is manifesting itself, something like Eve tried to do. She tried to have more light to manufacture something. That's why they don't manufacture nothing. The spirit is coming. Don't try to manufacture. Let us pray. What are you doing? Who are you blowing? Let us pray. Jesus. Don't manufacture nothing. Lift up your hands and pray. Are you following me now? The church is trying to manufacture something. I'm done. But we've done the same thing. Trying to make something in ourselves. Keep your hand off of it. I get it. Keep your hand on it. The brethren, sometimes they will come to me and I say, what is your problem? Are you a minister? That's a minister's place. Don't get there. Are you getting it? It's not because, look, if everybody here will be a minister, that's good. But if God doesn't place that call upon your heart, stay away from ministers. Are you following me? You don't know, if you are not a minister, stay off ministers' WhatsApp platforms. You don't belong there. It's not your place. Are you following me? Be careful. Because you pick a spirit you can't handle. Are you getting me now? Get into a place you don't belong. Stay in your place. If you are a deacon, stay in your place. Stay in your place. You are beating the tambourine, stay in your place. Be a son of God there. Don't get out of place. Amen. Keep your hand off of it. Let God do it. Take his word and believe it. Hold it in your heart. And when the rain begins to fall, life will take a hold. And the word will manifest itself. Are you ready? The word will manifest itself. You could be sitting here. Maybe God has called you to be the pastor of this church. Are you following me now? Stay in your place. At the right time, the rain will fall. Don't be in a hurry. God is the one that places kings and puts them down. Just get the word in you. Then when the rain falls, positionally it will place you. And if the church is sold with something else beside the word, it can't go to meet him. That's paragraph 70 of the same message. The end time seed sign, and I'm done. If the church is sold with something else beside the word, it can't go to meet him. He hasn't got a freak body with fungus on it. You see why we're trying to tell people to be in order? Every gift needs to be placed. Brother says, set in order. But if your gift is contrary to that, how can we set it in order? We clap like this and you are. How can we? We can't set you in order. If you are all jumping and you are sitting down, you won't get up and praise. How can we set you in order? So everything has its way. Christ is expecting a bride. Hallelujah. And now you see it. So you can tell. When you go to the spoken word church, you can tell. Look at the way they play their music. From there, you go to Pentecost. Will you miss anything? The same confusion. You don't know what is happening. Music is here, drums are here, and the song leader just, yeah, next one. What kind of nonsense is that? God is a God of order. Are you getting me now? And when you compare the music, record them and listen. You must hear rhythm. You must hear melody. You must hear inspiration. What a bunch of noise. Huh? I get it. So the problem is that when you come, leave your denominational ideas. Come into the bride. Because there's churches, churches, there's bride's bride. But there's coming forth one that are God's spirit of his spirit, life of his life, word of his word.
Amen.
They say that it's a fool who cannot change his mind. Are you getting it? When you go to Rome, do as the Romans. When you come to the message, do as the message. If I go to a place they preach and they don't say amen, I'll preach normal. I don't even get one amen. I'll still preach and go. I'm not there to change them. The word should change them. Because that is how they are made up. It's not my business. I'm not a pastor there. But when it comes here, you better rise up and praise him. I go yank that spirit off of you. Why? The word must come in there. Bring you up to the standard of the bride. I don't go to Catholic church now and begin to tell the seven thunders give faith. What will the Pope know about seven thunders give faith? Are you getting me now? Aha. The church has saw something else beside the word. It can't go to meet him. He hasn't got a freak body with fungus on it. He's got a perfect body. And he's the perfect word. And the church will be sown and believed in the perfect word. Everything that prophet said, we will say it. Because it is the perfect word. And the perfect word and the perfect word will unite us as one flesh and one body. Are you getting that? The perfect word and the perfect word will unite us as one perfect body. One flesh and one body as a husband and wife is amen. I am not amening myself, but amen means so be it to me. So be it to me. Unite me with the perfect word, Lord. Oh, I believe it anyhow. The former rain went forth. The rain is fixing to fall. What is it going to bring forth? You just watch. You just watch. The latter rain is about to fall. It will produce sons and daughters of God that are ready to bring down the coming of the Lord. It is going forth now. The word has been sowed. Praise God. You just watch that rain come down. Oh, now are we the sons and daughters of God? Let us bring on the manifestation of God in our life. May the Lord bless you. Keep your fire burning. Oh, now are we the sons of God. God bless you.
Amen, amen, amen. Give him praise, give him praise, give him praise. Oh, thank him this afternoon. Lift up your hands. Amen. Oh, just worship the Lord. Amen for the word, the power in it that has come to our hearts. Hallelujah. Power is to live by the word of the Lord. Amen. Which you can only get through. Amen. Preaching. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. I don't know why Jesus loved me. Oh, I don't know why. He cared. Oh, I don't know why he sacrificed his life. Oh, but I'm glad so that he did. Oh, I don't know why Jesus loved me. Oh, I don't know why he cared. Oh, I don't know why he sacrificed his life. Oh, I'm blessed Oh, so glad he did. Oh, where would I be if Jesus didn't love me? Oh, where would I be if Jesus didn't care? Oh, where would I be? Oh, if he hadn't sacrificed his life. Oh, but I'm glad, so glad he did. Where was he? Where would I be if Jesus didn't love me? Oh, just imagine that this afternoon. Oh, where would I be if Jesus didn't care? Oh, where would I be if he hadn't sacrificed? Oh, but I'm glad, oh, so glad he did. I don't know why, I don't know why Jesus loved me. Oh, I don't know why he cared. Oh, I don't know why he sacrificed his life. Oh, but I'm glad, oh, so glad. Oh, yes, worship him, give him praise, hallelujah. I don't know why, but he cared for me. I don't know why, oh, he sacrifices love over something that I know, but I'm glad that he did, because it made me who I am today. It brought me out there into the body of Christ and set me, hallelujah, aside for service. Amen. And so I'm glad today that I can sing it. Where would I be if he didn't love me? Where would I be if he did not care? Where would I be if he hadn't sacrificed that love? Amen. So I could live. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, we give you all the glory. We give you all the praise. Father, may you be with us now. Lord God, may you quicken our spirits. Father, Lord, oh, we thank you for everything. Day after day after day, Lord, our spirit increase, our faith build up. Oh, our step ahead, oh, into the spirit, into the perfection of God. Getting close, hallelujah. Getting prepared, getting cleansed up, getting holy, oh God, for adoption, Father, oh, for the dynamics to come upon the mechanics, Father, oh, that we can be ignited on, hallelujah, oh, to leave this place, to sing Hosanna, to go home, Father. Lord, we give you all the praise. Oh, you're all I want. Oh, you're all I ever needed. Oh, you're all I want. Oh, help me know you and him. Oh, hallelujah, you need him this afternoon. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Father, we thank you, Jesus. Oh, we give you all the praise. Amen. Just turn around and bless somebody. Amen. The Lord is good to us. Amen. Oh, I am covered, covered, covered by the blood. Oh, and walking by faith, holy. Well, I am covered, 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 and covered by his blood. Well, that Jesus has rescued me. I am covered, I am covered. Oh, yes, hallelujah. Oh, and walking, oh, yes, living. Oh, yes, I am covered, covered. Oh, covered by. Hallelujah. Now Jesus has rescued me. Oh, he's coming down, down, down. He's coming down. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, and the saints begins to pray for our Lord to have his will. And the Spirit of the Lord is coming. Oh, he's coming down, he's coming down, 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 he's coming down. Hallelujah, oh, and the Spirit. Oh, hallelujah, when the saints begins to pray for the Lord. Hallelujah, when the Spirit of the Lord is coming down. Oh, I've been singing since the Lord brought me out. Oh, hallelujah, I've been singing since the Lord brought me out. Oh, heaven had. Oh, tell me where. Oh, yes, I've been singing since the Lord brought me out. I've been shouting, I've been shouting since the Lord, he brought me out, I've been shouting. Since the Lord brought me out. Oh, even had not. Oh, my brother, where? Oh, yes, I've been. Since the Lord brought me out. I've been singing. Singing, singing. Oh, hallelujah. Brought me out. Oh, even. Hallelujah. I've been singing since the Lord brought me out. Hallelujah. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. Amen, amen. Is that what you're doing now? Amen. It says hold on to that word. Hallelujah. And never get weary. Amen. Never get tired. Amen. Never get fed up with this word. For it is the word of the Lord. And it's a promise unto your life, amen, to redeem you, hallelujah, take you home. Blessed be the name of the Lord, amen. You love the Lord, amen. This afternoon, the day has been a good day, amen. What a word to start a week, amen. May you be blessed by this word, and may this word guide you, hallelujah, amen, throughout the week, amen, and give you faith, amen, to trust in the Lord. For the word of the Lord is sure, it cannot fall down, and it would not return unto God void, but it's going to accomplish whatever it was set for. And that is the purpose we hold in this season. And we are looking up to that sign, amen, because that sign is going to appear. Amen. That is your faith this afternoon. Amen. And God bless you for coming. Amen. Shall we just pray? Father, we thank you this day. Lord, our hearts are glad. And why? Because we have experienced your presence, Father. It is all that we need. It gives us hope to hold on to that word. Because that word, Father, is all that we come to seek. Because when that word is, that is where the Spirit of the Lord is also. Father, bless my sister. Bless my brother. Oh God, give them faith, Father. Lord God, may you make a provision for them. Lord, even when they fall, Lord God, let them rise again to strength. Unto strength, Father, unto strength, Lord, believing that your word is the only refuge we have. It is where we run to, oh hallelujah, for shelter, Father. Lord, may you give us strength, Father, Lord of the faith, oh God. And let this faith not just be in word, oh God, but let it be in action, Father, and demonstration, Lord, because you promised that word in St. John 14:12. Amen. The greater things shall we do, oh God, because that word, oh hallelujah, is going to be in the bride, and that bride is going to pick up that word, oh mighty Jesus, and demonstrate the works of the Lord, and the world will see Jesus in man walking on 2 feet again for the manifestation of the word. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Father, we thank you, Lord. May you be with us, Lord. Father, oh God, we thank you for everything that you're doing for us, Father. And we acknowledge it today in giving you all the glory, because we know, Oh, hallelujah. Where that help is coming from? Where that provision is coming from? Where who is guiding us, Father? Oh, that still small voice that speaks to our conscience, Lord. We know where it is coming from. It comes to shape us, Father, not to get out there, but to stay within the confines of the word and the protection of God. We thank you for your abundance of love and grace. May you be with us throughout this week, Father. Lord, we thank you for even your servant, God, who brought that word, oh, Jesus Christ, oh, on the table, Father, for the feasting to take place, Father. Lord, I believe that the people have feasted enough. They have eaten enough of it. And it's just okay to keep us in the world, to keep us powerful, that every sickness will leave, that every contrast spirit will leave. Oh, God, that we will keep it in our families, and it shall be a provision to us, Father, in all that we need, Lord. We ask all of this in Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Oh, you love him. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Amen. God richly bless you for coming. Amen. It shall not be in vain. Your labor will bring back the promises of God. Amen. Upon thee and your family. God bless you. You may be seated even as amen. Amen. The brothers get ready to dismiss. Hallelujah. Oh, let's talk about Jesus. He is a king. Who is Lord of lords, supreme, through our eternity. Oh, the great I am, the way, the truth, the life, the door. Oh, let's talk about Jesus. God bless you. Oh, sing, let's talk about Jesus, the King of kings. Oh, the Lord of lords, supreme. Oh, throughout eternity. Oh, yes, the great I am. Oh, the truth. Oh, let's talk about Jesus more and more. Oh, sing, let's talk about Jesus. Oh, the King of kings is he. Oh, the Lord of lords supreme. Oh, throughout eternity, the great I am, the way, the truth, the life. Oh, let's talk about Jesus more and more. Oh, let's talk about Jesus, the King of kings is he, the Lord of lords supreme to all eternity. Oh, the great I am, the way, the truth, the life, the door. Let's talk about Jesus more and more.